Hello everyone, welcome to part 134 of ecom series in Laravel 5.7 and 5.8. And in this video we are going to work on filters once again. In last video we have seen that we able to implement the color filter, okay? So now in this video we are going to work on sleeve filter as well. Sleeve filter we have not added so far from admin panel, and we will also work on pattern filter in later videos, and we will also work on size filter as well. So size filter also we are going to do in few videos. So number of filters we are going to work on in this video and the next few videos. Okay, so see here, we have implemented the color filter in last video, and in this video we are going to implement the sleeve filter. But sleeve filter normally in our e-commerce website, that these are the common filters that we are going to do, like color filter is the common filter, size filter is the common filter, and sleeve and pattern filters are also common. So you require to implement this kind of filter, and we need to add option from admin panel. We need to make sure that we have added the option in admin panel to add these filters, otherwise you can't add to products. Okay, so let's log into the admin panel. Okay, so here in products you can able to see. Okay, so just need to go to products. Okay, and here you can see this, and here you can see that in the last video we have worked on product color, and product color we have the test field, and now sleeve filter we are going to have that drop down in sleeve filter. So because there are particular type of sleeves, like full sleeves, half sleeves, short sleeves, so there are just 3-4 types of sleeves, and we are going to add here drop down so that the admin can add from those options only. Okay, so first of all, we are going to update the products table with sleeve. Okay, so let's do that thing first, and we can update from Phpmyadmin, or we can update from migration. For saving time, I'm going to update straight away here. Okay, so I can add this option after care or anywhere you want. You must add with the other options like this one. So don't add at the last, because it will make sense to add with other kind of means attributes, like description here. And after care I am going to put this one, and after care I'm going to add one column, that is sleeve. Okay, so I'm going to add this column sleeve. Okay, I'm going to make this like VARCHAR 255. Okay, so I'm going to save it. And okay, so yeah, now it has been done. Okay, you can see my sleeve has been added with VARCHAR 255. Okay, so after adding this, we need to show in here also sleeve, but before showing, we need to update in add product function. Okay, in add product function we are going to one array that is called sleeve array. So we are going to add one array so that we can send the particular sleeve option that the admin can select from. Okay, so I'm going to make one sleeve array like this, and here I'm going to add array, and I'm going to add the particular options like full sleeve, okay, so half sleeve like this, and short sleeve, and whatever option you like you can add. Okay, from your end, short sleeve. Okay, and also we are going to add sleeveless. Okay, like this. Okay, so this sleeve array we are going to send here like this. Okay, sleeve array we can send like this, and this sleeve array now we are going to update first add product blade file. Add product blade file, this is the file that we are going to update, and here after material and care we can add that sleeve option. Okay, So we can simply copy one of the view, and after that we just need to update here, and here I'm going to add sleeve, and here I am going to give that select option, like select name I'm going to give sleeve, okay. And after that I'm going to give class form control, like this, okay. Okay, so yeah, now select option we have added, and after that we are going to add option here, the value can be select sleeve, okay, like this, okay. So after this okay, option value select sleeve, and now after for each, like this, and dollar sleeve array that we have made in function, okay, as dollar sleeve, like this, and inside this we are going to repeat this value, so that getting here like dollar sleeve, okay. And once again add sleeve, like this, okay. So and here we need to close and foreach, okay. Now we are going to check here, and we'll see that its option must have been added, and here we are forgot to end select option, okay. And we can make it like this, and now we can refresh once again, and we'll see that the option has come here, select sleeve, okay. You can see that the option has come here, okay. So now in edit as well, we want the option in edit as well, and now here also we want to have that option. So but first of all we will complete the add portion, that after adding it we need to add here in column as well. So we need to update here add product function, still we need to update that sleeve value that we will get. So we need to update add product function, and like description we will make that, because sleeve is not mandatory. So if this sleeve is there, then we are going to add in product table sleeve option, we are going to add. If it is not empty, then we are going to add, otherwise we are going to make it means we will just initialize it so that it will not give any error, okay. So after this one, and now it must work fine. Now we can add new product, we can try adding new product, any of the product we can add, like in casual t-shirt, okay. So I will add like sleeveless t-shirt, okay, like this, okay. And here I will add like these, any code you can add, product color, we can quickly add one product, any product you can add, red t-shirt or anything you can add, okay. So you just need to add, need to open, and you can save, or you can have from any of the image you can have, no issue, okay. So you can add this for just for testing purpose, okay. So close, and now here you can just give red and description nothing required, and here I'm going to put sleeveless, but okay, so now I will search sleeveless t-shirt, sorry for that, and I will add some sleeveless t-shirt, okay. So yeah, now I can add any of this sleeveless t-shirt, okay, like this, okay. So going to add like this one, and but no issue, okay, no issue, blue is also fine, and I'm going to save it, and now here I am going to make it blue, and Here I'm going to set sleeveless, that is fine, and this shirt I have added. Okay, enable, that is fine, and I'm going to add this product. Okay, so we are going to see, we are going to check that whether after adding this one, we are going to check in database table. Okay, so wait for few minutes and then we are going to see. Oh, here is some issue. Column price cannot be null, and I think we forgot to add the price here, and so that's why issue is coming. We need to make this field mandatory as well, so that it will tell us that that this field is required. So add the validations as well, okay, from your end. And now we are going to check that whether the sleeveless t-shirt, sleeveless, you can see that in sleeve column we able to get that sleeveless, okay. From the number of sleeve options, we able to get the sleeveless. Okay, so now is the time to edit this option in case you have added the wrong option or you want to edit for some reason. So you can simply need to edit that. Okay, this is the blue t-shirt that we have added. So I want your option as well. So I'm going to do that similar kind of thing. First of all, I'm going to update that edit product function with the sleeve array, okay, so that we can pass that sleeve array to edit form as well, edit product form as well. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to pass that to edit product form. Here I'm going to do that like this, and this sleeve array we are going to pass to edit product form, okay, like this. And after that, after it edit, okay, so this, and here we are going to do like this, edit product. Okay, so here we have entered, and here we need to add of here as well, but we will pick from here. Same, we can pick after material and care, we can add this one. Okay, here we can add material and care. Okay, so here we need the option, here we need to check that if sleeve is coming from product table or not. Same product details, object sleeve. Okay, and we are going to check if that sleeve is not empty, and we are going to compare with sleeve, this one sleeve that is coming in foreach loop. And if it is matching with this sleeve, that the coming sleeve, if it is matching, then we are going to means that selector option we are going to do for that. Okay, so here we are going to add that thing, get of if, first of all, not empty. Okay, I'm going to check that this one in this array, in this JSON array, JSON object, it is not empty. And after that, we are going to check and this must be equal to that sleeve. Okay, sleeve must be equal to dollar sleeve, this one. Okay, so like this, and after that we are going to select this option, selected, and after that end like this. Okay, so now we are going to check that whether it is out of, it must select automatically, and the field must come here. You can see that it is automatically selecting sleeveless, automatically selecting here. Okay, whatever the option we have given in add add product form, it is also auto selected in here, sleeve option. Okay, so now if we want to change, we can able to change, but we need to make sure that we need to update in edit product function as well. Okay, so the same thing we are going to do in edit product function, like we have done in add product function, and this thing we are going to do in edit product function as well, but this time it going to be a little bit different. Like here we are not going to do like this, because we are not adding any kind of here product object, any kind of product query. Okay, so here we will do like this, that sleeve If not empty, then it is coming in dollar sleeve variable. That dollar sleeve variable we are going to take for getting the dollar data sleeve that is coming from the form, and otherwise it is sleeve. Dollar sleeve must be initialized only with empty value. Okay, and here in the previous attempt we are doing new product kind of thing, that here we for new product we have done like this, but here we are updating, so just we need to get the data, and here this sleeve option we just need to update. Here after this one we can do this very simply like this. Okay, so this is the option. And another way, there is also another way to do, like if you want to do in a similar way like you have done in add product, you can also, like in place of new you will do like find and that ID kind of thing. So there is also way, but here we are doing like this, so we must follow this one only. And you can do like this, that first you can get sleeve, and after that you can save here like this in update form. Okay, so after this one, we are going to test this, and I will see that if we update this option, then it must update here as well. Okay, so if I will do like short sleeve, and I'm going to edit product, I'm going to click on edit product, and we'll see that if it has been updated. You can see that it has been updated as well. Now it is coming like short sleeve. Okay, and we are going to check here as well, and you can able to see that sleeve is having short sleeve. It is working fine. Okay, so like this we can update for all products. Okay, and we can have this one like sleeve, and this option we are going to give in detail and in listing page as well. As a part of filter, here we are going to give sleeve. Okay, and in detail page as well we are going to give sleeve here as well, because we want to show the option that this product is having. We want to show that what this product is having, complete description we want to show, and of course in listing page as well as a part of filter. Here we are going to show the sleeve, and all these sleeves will come here, and whatever we are going to select, then it those sleeve types will come here. Okay, so now I hope that everything is clear to you up till now, and we are going to now show filter of sleeve in the next video, and we will also do pattern like this, and after that we will also work on size filter as well. Okay, so stay tuned for that, and if you have any queries you can surely contact me at video description. Okay, so that's all for now, and have a nice time. Goodbye.